This installment of our History of Sabre Yachts interview series is with Mr. Glenn Campbell, our engineering manager. Good morning, Glenn.
Good morning.
Why don't you start out by telling our viewers a little bit about how you ended up at Sabre?
Well, that's an interesting story. It's now a lot of years ago now, almost 23 years ago. I was still in college and studying manufacturing. And I was basically looking for a summer internship, summer employment, and finished up my school. And so I applied for just a regular position at Sabre Yachts and met with a production manager. And shortly thereafter, I got a postcard in the mail saying, our naval architect on staff would really like to meet with you. So can you make another interview with us? So I went up and I met with Kendra Senek, who was the naval architect on staff at that time, and had a nice discussion meeting with him, and no sooner got home and the phone rang and I said, when can you start? And so that's 23 years later, here I am. Early on, a lot of our CAD work and drafting is fourth quarter. We're two-dimensional drawings and 2D CAD. And now, of course, that's all 3D parametric models with assemblies and so forth. I can even remember when I first started, there were several drawings that were truly regular pencil drawn drawings that I would do revisions to with by hand. I can always remember we had a pen plotter that had a single pen in it, and if you had a big drawing to plot, it could take 20 minutes to an hour if it was very detailed for that pen plotter to make one drawing. And then we had a blueprint machine to make copies of that and so forth. And of course now we've got color, you know, e-size printers that are inkjet. Some of our electrical systems, the most complicated things when I first started, was maybe a three-way light circuit switch. We thought that was pretty, you know, complex. And now the integrated systems we use now in a fully networked boat that we're evolving to more and more, that's like the new holy grail of boat building.
Our brands have a particular relationship between the design department and the engineering department, and sort of the gray area or the spectrum where things start getting handed over. Can you tell us a little bit about what that process is like from your end?
Right, so from our perspective, what happens in the Sabre builds, Kevin and Adam and the design team in Auckland, they'll put a wealth of effort and time into developing the conceptual layouts and sort of what I call the long lines of where it boat will look and feel and the overall concept of it. And they'll start to work out some of those details, and then at a given point where it makes good sense and we're ready in our engineering department, we start to receive those sort of stepping off stones or stepping stones of build, and our team takes over and starts laying out the joinery. Start working out the finer details of the laminate construction, and all the details that go into it.
We're sitting on your newest project right now, or on the very first Sabre 58. I'm wondering if you can tell me a little bit about what it's like engineering that prototype boat, because I imagine it's a very different animal from the other boats that come after it down the line.
Well, the first thing I always emphasize is it's definitely a big team effort, and I'm blessed with a team of guys under me in our department of engineering that really, they are really talented guys. And, you know, the fit finish, the execution of all these systems and joiner work and the whole gamut is really kudos to their workmanship and their efforts to be the best we can be. The things that you've never done before will often be the most challenging, because there's the things you didn't know you didn't know, and they arise in the process, but it's a great learning experience. Our work on our 66 model, for instance, really helped develop our understanding ability and really made this 58, I think, successful the way it is now. It was definitely, that gave us a wealth of understanding of what goes into these network boats to have a jump start on.
You've talked about how, you know, when you first started, a three-way light switch was innovative and you were dealing with, you know, pen plotters and blueprints, and now we've moved into the world of not only 3D rendering and modeling, but also, you know, integrated systems on our boats and things like that. If I were to ask you to speculate a little bit on, you know, what the future of those engineering innovations will be, do you have anything in particular that you see coming down the line, or you'd like to see, or we'd like to move into?
Well, I see a lot of growth in technology on 3D printed parts. I think as that technology gets more refined, there'll be applications for that as well, where literally from a CAD model to a material selection to hit print, you'll have a finished part of a component, which will allow a lot of more complexity and if not early on here for the actual finished parts of a finished boat, definitely for prototyping sake.